Ganeto.
Hello trainers, Ganeto here with some toxic apaxion from a tournament I have just won. However, this is not my weighted cap of this month and the winning is not the main purpose. The main goal is to see how my team performs and test it out in more intense battles. The team is consisted of the star of this team, Biberel with Water Gun, Surf and Hyper Fang. Quillfish with Water Gun, Aqua Tail and Felstinger for some crazy outplays. Wormadam Trash, which is no trash at all, with Confusion, Bugbuzz and Iron Head. Gliscor, my Ground Flyer and a considerable safe switch for this cap, with Wing Attack, Night Slash and Earthquake. Meganium with Vine Whip, Frenzy Plant and Earthquake for the nukes. And finally, we've got Steelix. Crunch and Earthquake as usual, but this one runs Thunderfang. Couldn't be happier for that, even the Water Gunners are in threat. You can see my thoughts on how I built this team in the link that pops up on the upper corner of this video right now. Anyway, this is a 4-round tournament with some Ace Trainers and a bunch of Challengers. Tournament's link will always be in the description. Since this is not a weighted one, stakes may not be high but skills are for sure. You may have noticed that my team lacks a fighter. However, it has some special combos like the Water Gun Duo. But without any further ado, let's hop into the tournament! Okay, after winning the first battle, we proceed on the second one and we are facing a Biberel with our Quillfish. This is not a very good scenario for my team because I have in the back a Biberel and a Wormadam. I have to stick with that Quillfish. Using the Felstinker, trying to raise my attack, and I'm hoping right now that this is going to be a surf. Unfortunately, that's not the case, the Hyper Fang will come through and Quillfish will be fainted. Bringing out my own Biberel this time, trying to at least take a surf at this point, but it is a Hyper Fang. I did not shield that, that was very bad for me. Things are not looking so good because he has two more Pokemon in the back. My first opponent is Kostas Las. I have played against him in a bunch of tournaments. He's a very good trainer, a very skilled one. Using his Golbat now and I'm having my Wormadam into play, trying to do some cheap damage with those Confusions before he's switching out at his Gliscor. The Gliscor is a decent counter to the Wormadam, actually not a counter but a Pokemon that can just put quite the fight against the Wormadam and even win in some scenarios if it lands the Earthquake. Anyway, we have to use that Iron Head right now, trying to take out this Gliscor. He decides to shield, of course, doesn't want to have a matchup against the Wormadam with his Golbat. We have to shield as well, we don't have a very good and healthy Biberel in the back. And since we have both no shields, I decide to bring out my Biberel to take out this Gliscor with a Surf. The Golbat will finish me off with fast attacks and it is pretty much GG at this point because the Shadow Ball will connect and take out my Wormadam. We both have one win and we're trying to see right now on this round who will be victorious. We're having the Wormadam mirror and I know that I just have to go straight Bugbuzz as my opponent will do the same. Trying to hit that Bugbuzz and take out as much HP as I can from this Wormadam. He will do the same of course. The Bugbuzzes are not going to hurt a lot and it is a boring matchup like an Azumarill against the Registeel matchup. Anyway, we just have to stick with those Wormadams, hitting another Bugbuzz at this point, dealing a decent amount of damage. It is not a very effective move as well. We will do the same, trying to hit the Bugbuzz, and I know that my Wormadam has almost perfect PvP IV stats, so we will take that win. Here is a situation where IVs do matter. They will bring out their Golbat, and Golbat will face my Steelix now. This is a very good scenario for me and I have my Meganium in the back. I was hoping that I would catch a Biberel, but Meganium can also win against the Gliscor, especially now that I have slightly the energy advantage. Anyway, I brought out my Steelix because I thought that he might have a Golbat and a Biberel in the back. Of course, that was my thinking and I almost went into that because he had the Golbat but he didn't have a Biberel, he had the Gliscor. Doesn't matter though, as I have won the lead matchup and winning the switch advantage. And now my Meganium is paired with that Gliscor. We can take that Night Slash, both of our shields are down, immediately switch out to my Steelix to absorb that Poison Fang. It would deal literally nothing. And I'm having to land a Crunch at this point to put that Golbat very low. A Shadow Ball will not hurt us. We will be low, but not that low. The Shadow Ball will connect. We are almost in the red bar of HP. We can take that Night Slash, no problem, and then land a Crunch. The Night Slash will not be enough to take us out. The Crunch will connect, and eventually we will take this first win in the first round of this 4-round tournament. Okay, we're having the next opponent, and that is going to be Mirutokun. We're having a very smart lead there with the Meganium catching up the Bibarel. But he makes a very good switch at his own Golbat. That will be the reason that my Meganium misses that Frenzy Plant. It will deal almost nothing at the Golbat. We can take the Shadow Ball with our Wormadam and then continue on our strategy in farming down this bat. We can take this Poison Fang. We knew that it was going to be a Poison Fang. No reason to shield at all. This bat had no time at all to charge up to a Shadow Ball. The Bibarel will come up next and it will face my Bugbuzz. Probably was thinking about I was going for the Iron Head because I landed a charge move blindly. So that is the reason that he might have not shielded it. Anyway, I'm bringing out my Gliscor and my opponent has a Toxicroak in the back. A very good counter to the Toxicroak. Despite the confusion users, Toxicroak loses to the Gliscor as well. The Wing Attacks will do a lot of damage. The Sludge Bomb will do damage as well, even though it is a not very effective move, but we have two shields up. We can just go ahead and use a Night Slash and then take this win. We are heading up to the second match of the second round and we are facing a Wormadam. We have to bail out immediately using the double water gunner strategy over there, and after I'm bringing out my Wormadam, he decides to bring out the Golbat. A very good switch because he wants that Wormadam to be paired with my Quillfish, as he can just farm it down. This Golbat will unleash a Shadow Ball and I have to block it. I want to keep my Wormadam healthy just in case there is a Toxicroak in the back. Using my Bugbuzz right now, trying to do some cheap damage to this Wormadam. I know that I don't have a very good solution, a very good answer against this threat. Anyway, we will take this Bugbuzz and switch out to my Bibarel. And after I do that, they bring out that Toxicroak and it is pretty much a GG because he can just farm it down by blocking once. Here comes the first block and I cannot reach even to the 50% energy needed for that surf. And right now I have to bring out my Quillfish because my Wormadam is so low that two counters would just take me out. Using the Quillfish, I don't want to get paired with the Wormadam, but it is already a GG, another Mad Bomb. I was so tilted at this moment and we will take this loss even though we managed to take out the Toxicroak. So far this double water gun strategy doesn't seem to be so helpful, but anyway we have one more chance to wrap this up and we are facing a Piloswine. Piloswine is a very interesting Pokemon, a very high ranking one, but people don't seem to like it at all. Mirutokun of course use it very often I believe, and we will take that Bulldoze into the face, dealing a nice amount of damage to my tanky Bug Steel Pokemon. I'm trying to hit an Iron Head over there, trying to take out this Piloswine, but he decides to shield. They will try to just answer back with an Avalanche. I have to block it because I thought it was going to be a Bulldoze. Then I'm trying to use an Iron Head back. Let's see if they shield, and they don't, they take it. So we have won the switch advantage and have enough energy to unleash another charge move eventually to that Wormadam. We will use the Bugbuzz, but we have nothing to fear, and after using the Bugbuzz, they will take us out with just Confusions. That is not very bad for us because we have a Steelix and a Gliscor in the back. Steelix is literally a wall to everything that a Wormadam can throw at it. We can take them. The Thunder Fang and the Dragon Tail are both very effective against that War Madame, we can take any move. As I said before, a backbuzz will come through, no problem if we get very low, and I thought that this was going to be a Toxicroak, so that's why I switched out as well. Anyway, we have the Gliscor against the Golbat, and we just have to go straight Night Slashes. We can take that charge move even if it was a Shadow Ball, we could withstand it and then land a Night Slash. Eventually they would have fainted us, but that is not the case, as my Steelix is very good at taking out flyers as well. My Flying Scorpion will faint, but Steelix will win this match for me with an Earthquake against the War Madame. Unfortunately, my recorder decided to not record on the next round against a very skillful trainer named Neverland Exists. Therefore, we will head to the big final after I came victorious from the semi-finals. We're facing Head Sotos. Those matches are very interesting, so be sure to stick around till the end. Meganium is no match for the War Madame, so I have to switch out to my safe switch, my Flying Scorpio, the Gliscor, hitting the buff against the War Madame, and they bring out the B-Barrel to take us out. Of course, we will land another Night Slash over there, hoping that this will go through. That doesn't matter though, because they proceed in just hitting that Surf. That's very good for me, because that B-Barrel now has no energy left. We can bring out safely my Meganium to just farm down all the way through. We know that we can get hit by Hyper Funk, it deals about 50% of my HP, and then just proceed in just finishing down. Now we have a lot of energy stored up, even though we don't have much HP, and I'm thinking about this has to be a War Madame, but it is just a Pidgeot. That's very bad, because I decided to unleash an Earthquake that will go through unshielded, but I have a Steelix in the back which can handle both the War Madame and the Pidgeot just as fine. We have nothing to worry about and to shield from that War Madame. The backbuzz is a very bad move against my Steel typing. Trainers, if you're thinking about running Steelix in your line of 6, I definitely recommend you to use Thunderfang. It goes much better against the B-Barrel and the Quillfish, you have nothing to fear, and it is a much better move against those Steel typings. Of course, it will not charge up as easy as it does with the Dragon Tail, but it will be a much more efficient move. Hitting that Crunch, it will be shielded, and after that I make a right on point switch to absorb the Hurricane. After the Hurricane, it is very easy for my Steelix to straight Thunderfang down this Pidgeot and eventually take the win. Right now we're just one match away, one win away from taking this tournament. Okay, we're having a bad lead over there against the Pidgeot. We have to use some Confusions and then bail out to my Gliscor, a very good safe switch, using the Night Slash, and let's see if it goes through. And it does, dealing a decent amount of damage. We can take one Aerial Ace, no problem I believe. I decided to shield, of course, because I thought that it might have been a Hurricane. He did farm a lot on my War Madame. That was not the case. We can take an Aerial Ace at this point. It is not a very good move and not very efficient one, using a Night Slash. And let's see if we can hit the buff right now. We do not. But that doesn't matter, because we can hit one more before fainting down. That will provoke the last shield, I believe, and it does. This is very good for us. Now we are sealed up and we are having a Steelix up in front, but he has two health Pokemon as well in the back, using the Aerial Ace, and then just finish off with just a Thunderfang. The Toxicroak will come through, and I have to land an Earthquake if I want to succeed, using a shield over there, because the Mud Bomb would have eventually knocked out me. Using the Earthquake, that will seal the deal against this Toxicroak. The Toxicroak will be fainted, and then the last Pokemon is going to be a Hippodon. Very bad news for my team, because both Steelix and War Madame have very bad matchups against fire attacks. Anyway, we'll take this Body Slam, trying to land a Backbuzz, perhaps having a chance in winning this match, but it will not be enough. The Farfangs will find us down, and then without energy left and very low HP, the Steelix will go down as well. So Here you have it, trainers, the final of the finals. We are facing, with Albi Barel, a very bad lead, the Toxicroak. Things are not looking so good, but we are having a Gliscor. Gliscor will use the Night Slash, trying to hit the buff and eventually take out this Pidgeot. We will hit the buff, very good for us, and it happened in the final of the finals. Using an Aerial Ace by our opponent, we can take it and then use a Night Slash back at them. This will provoke the first shield, that is very good for me, because now with the buff I can just finish off with wing attacks. We have to shield that move, whatever it is. Of course it is going to be an Aerial Ace, no reason to go for the Hurricane, and then just fade down with fast attacks. We now have the switch advantage. Gliscor has done its job, and that is very good because we can just land a Night Slash before fainting. We both have one shield up using the Night Slash. That will not deal a lot of damage to the Toxicroak, but enough to put it severely low, using the Wormadam, and then after he switches out at the B barrel, we will do the same, and that is very good for me because I have the upper hand right now. We get hit by the Surf, no problem if that was a Hyper Fang as well. We will use a Hyper Fang at our part, trying to take out this B barrel, and we do. The shield never came up. Very good for us, we don't have to shield as well, we can take this move. It's going to be another Surf, a not very effective move. We will get defeated, but that doesn't matter because that Wormadam with a shield up can take out this B barrel and take out this Toxicroak. That's it, everyone, we came out victorious from this Toxicap tournament. Very good games, some of which were so clutch. B-Barrel may be the star, but Gliscor is surely the real MVP by being the safe switch. I know that most of you trainers are concerned about Go Battle League content more, but in Sylph Arena and in tournaments like this, battles require more strategy as the meta is more fun and practically they are a battle of 6 instead of 3. I really hope you enjoy content like this and tell me your thoughts in the comments. I'm really sorry about the quality of the clips and the semi-final that was missing. Voyager is the cup that is announced for the next month. Link for everything will be in the description. Be sure to leave a like or even subscribe if you're new. And I'll see you all on the next one.